Hi, my name is Dr. Brian Curtis. I'm one of the paleontologists here at Fossil Crates. And today I'm here to talk about this gorgeous creature behind me. It's Dilophosaurus, the two-crested lizard. Because why not have two? It's better than one. Now, this animal is near and dear to my heart because I am born and raised in Arizona. I live in Arizona, and this animal was found in Arizona. So you can imagine my disappointment when I read the book and then saw the subsequent movie that talked about Dilophosaurus as a spitter. The little tiny cute dinosaur with the frill. That, unfortunately, is far from the truth. Now, I knew Sam Wells, the person that named and described this dinosaur, and he was pleased that his dinosaur made it into the movies. So he was okay with it. And I am too, I guess, but Dilophosaurus was no tiny little cute yellow hopping dinosaur. It was actually an over 20-foot long apex predator who dominated the early Jurassic landscape of Arizona. Now, Dilophosaurus is a really cool dinosaur, and they found a number of skeletons 100 miles apart. So as a result, we have some work that has been done recently that's gone through all of these skeletons. And it had four fingers on each hand. It had one large claw, and then two smaller claws, and then a tiny, almost vestigial claw. But its arms were long and powerful. And it had long legs and could run pretty quick. Dilophosaurus, when it was found, the skull was thought to be really weak because there's a lot of loose connections in its skull bones. Recent research, however, looked at the jaws and determined that, yeah, it was loosely put together, but it could still have quite the bite. It had very powerful rear jaw musculature. Now, Dilophosaurus has a famous sneer to it. That subnarial gap is the cool term for it, but sneer works as well. And it had large teeth. And unlike many dinosaurs, whose biggest teeth were up front, in Dilophosaurus, its largest teeth were in the back or towards the middle, like the front middle of the mouth, around the fourth tooth. So as a result, it has this really cool view and side view. The teeth get larger and then they get smaller again. These teeth are serrated front and back. So they have a serration here and a serration there, which will allow them to shred through. So though they didn't have the most powerful bite, they still had a strong bite. The nose of Dilophosaurus is located far back in its skull. Most median dinosaurs have the nose right up front. Animals whose nose is farther back, think about it, spinosaurids, and crocodiles, bitosaurs, these fish-eating type animals. So one concept has been proposed is that Dilophosaurus was a piscivorous animal that ate fish because of the location of its nose and because it has a subnarial gap like spinosaurs and the crocodiles, and because of its jaw musculature. When you have big, strong, powerful jaw muscles in the very back, that allows you to snap your jaw much quicker so you can bite down on a quick fish. Now, engineering analyses indicate that Dilophosaurus' jaw was perfectly capable of eating whatever it wanted. Dilophosaurus had roughly 70 teeth in its mouth. It's a lot of teeth. Fish-eating animals tend to have lots of teeth, and these teeth were replaced throughout its life. The Dilophosaurus skull, in relation to its body size, is surprisingly large. When you look at the Dilophosaurus skull, you're thinking something that's a fairly sizable, heavy beast. But when you actually look at the skeleton, you find that even though it's 23 feet long, it's not heavy. It just has a big head, which is really cool when you check it out. Those two crests, they were very fragile and thin and could not have been used for conflict of any sort. So they likely had either a thermoregulatory function where it kept track of its temperature and made it cooler or hotter by flushing blood up there or pulling it down. Or more likely, it was used to show off, hey, I'm ready to find a mate, or I'm really angry, or I'm in a great mood. It's hard to say what it was used for because it's 196 to 183 million years ago. So we're talking a long time ago. In a time of rocks that aren't particularly well known, a funny thing about Dilophosaurus to me is we don't really know where it fits into the meat eating record. Here's one of the earliest of the meat eaters, and its closest relative is Dracoraptor from South Africa. Now, the continents were in different places back then, and so it's not as shocking to find its closest relative to be on the other side of the world, but it is still interesting to see that it doesn't really fit in. On the phylogenetic analyses that have been done, other than being primitive, it falls over in a bunch of different places, depending on what characters are used. So we need more specimens to fill in this gap. When you think meat eaters, you think late Cretaceous, which was 66 million years ago, or you think like Tyrannosaurus rex, or you think Allosaurus, and its ilk, like Torvosaurus and Ceratosaurus, from 144 million years ago. But when you go 190 million years, even though we have meat eaters from them, they're just not well known. An interesting fun fact is Dilophosaurus has a trackway that's attributed to it. We don't 100% know it goes to Dilophosaurus, but it's the only track, to my knowledge, that starts off where the animal is crouching. So we know it's crouching because it has its hands, it has its feet, and then it has a tail mark as well. And then it pushes itself up, and then the hands disappear from the trackway, but the tip of the tail, midway back, is still there. The base of the tail is not, so it's standing up, and then it begins to walk. And as it walks, the tail ultimately leaves the ground completely. So again, to my knowledge, it's the only animal that has been discovered where we have a dinosaur getting up off the ground, which I think is so cool. Lots and lots of neat trackways up in northern Arizona. So it's a little bit about Dilophosaurus, one of the more iconic dinosaurs that people recognize, but they often recognize it for all the wrong reasons. Remember, Dilophosaurus was a more than capable apex predator in the early Jurassic and stomped around all over Arizona, likely would have been in New Mexico and other parts as well. So thank you kindly. Have a great day. Adios.